Well, a new twist to one of reality TV's longest-running shows. The upcoming season of Survivor is breaking up its tribes based on race. The announcement is drawing mixed reaction, to say the least. And here to talk about it, Fernando Mateo of Hispanics Across America and activist Jen Chau, co-founder of the diversity training team New Demographic. Great to see both of you.
Thank you. Thank
All you. Right, so Fernando, let me start with you. What in the world are the producers of Survivor thinking about here?
I think Mark Burnett is basically looking for more ratings. He's trying to get everyone to view this and root for their own ethnicity. I think that it's a smart business decision, but not every business decision is a good business decision. I believe that what he's trying to do is basically divide us as people so that everyone's rooting for their own. And I think that that's in very poor and bad taste.
Jen, for those of us who have seen Survivor, which is most of America by this point, there are plenty of things that go on in that show that divide the people anyway. So why add this very charged new element to the show?
Well, that is exactly my question. I mean, in a show where you have this obvious competition, which will include an assumed amount of dispute, you make these teams that are, you know, basically each race against another, you are bound to have a situation where you're creating more and more opportunities for racial conflict. It's my personal thought that we don't need to create more opportunities for that.
And Jen, what is going to happen when one tribe continually gets beaten every single week? What's the conversation in this country going to be like?
That is my concern. I can see the headlines now. Oh, we knew that this was the superior race, or we knew that that was the weaker race. I mean, I'm very concerned about the assumptions that are going to be made from what we see in this competition. And I'm also concerned about what will come out of these conflicts, you know, race versus race. I don't think it's a smart direction to be moving in.
You know, Fernando, the whole show Survivor is, the contestants are screened, they're psychologically screened, they're physically screened before they're cast onto the show, and they try, to the extent they can, to establish some sort of equality among the contestants so that it's a fair fight. And yet, this whole notion seems to denigrate the concept of equality to the point where you're going to have sort of a post-O.J. Simpson cheering squad in this country, you know, the post-O.J. Simpson verdict, where you had one race cheering the verdict and another race scratching their heads. I don't see how that's helpful culturally or in terms of the show.
I think at this point in this country, this is certainly the wrong decision. We're living an age of anti-immigration, of separation. And this show that everyone watches is just going to make it even worse. But I feel bad more so for the people that are going to be on the show. The pressure that they're going to have to succeed, and if they fail, they're going to let their people down. I mean, the mental strain that these actors or wannabe actors are going to face once they're done with the show, I think it's going to be terrible because their families are going to feel the pressure, their friends are going to feel the pressure, their communities are going to feel the pressure. And anywhere they go, if they lose, and if they lose badly, people are going to point them out. And it's wrong to separate us the way CBS has done. And I think they could have done a more effective job if they would have taken one of each different ethnic groups and put them into one group so that they all understand the different cultures, so that they all work as a team, so that they all work with their different abilities. And together they can form better groups. I think that that would have been a lot more exciting. But people always look for controversy. Controversy sells. It's like sex sells.
Well, that's
controversy
exactly,
sells.
That's exactly
and that's what
point.
Mark Burnett is looking for. He's looking to sell
what?
The show.
You know what, Jen? They look like they've succeeded because here we are talking about
Absolutely.
The new Survivor based on this. Jen, do you agree with Fernando that this is basically just shock value, that they are trying desperately to salvage a show that has really declined in the ratings?
I think so. I mean, in the article, in the first articles that I've seen about this, you know, they said, we really want to create more diversity. obviously, this is not the solution. Like Fernando was saying, you could have created these teams that were diverse within teams instead of pitting people against people. It's obviously to draw more attention. It's obviously to get people's ears to perk up. So I don't think that it's really, I don't think there's any good intention behind it. And I think it's just not in line with how our conversations about race are going today. I mean, if you think about society, science, we're moving away from this idea that there are these discrete categories of race, and this continues that conversation and is keeping us in that old way of discussing race. And I think that's also another harmful thing that's coming out of this.
Yeah, there was a monster in this world called Adolf Hitler, and what Adolf Hitler tried to do was divide races because he wanted to be the master race. He thought that they would be the master race. And in essence, you know, what are we trying to do with the CBS survival show? Try to prove who is the strongest race, who is the... Yeah, it throws a lot of curveballs, and I think that it's wrong.
Well, you know what, you guys? It's going to be very interesting to see how Mark Burnett and the rest of the CBS crew answer these kinds of questions. Mm-hmm. So great to see you. Thanks, Fernando Mateo and Jen Chau.
Thank you so much.
You bet. And how is the race-baiting edition of Survivor playing out in Scarborough Country? We're going to find out tonight at 9 Eastern Time right here on MSNBC.